guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to a new video. And hello if you are new here, welcome to my channel and welcome back to another, is it a weekly vlog? I don't really know. I'm starting vlogging, it's a Wednesday, so I don't know how long this vlog's gonna go on. It might go to the weekend, it might go next week. Let's see how interesting my life is. But I thought I would just start this weekly vlog now because I've just had the most exciting delivery. Like, I am so excited about this. I've been waiting about a week for this to arrive and it finally came today and I was like, ah, super exciting. So I thought I would do a little unboxing with you all to open up the vlog. Let me get my little box opener. Before we jump onto the video, if you're not already subscribed, would you please subscribe? I would really, really appreciate that. And yeah, the subscribe button should be here. It's somewhere on the screen. Please click it. I would love it if you did. Subscribe. Let's get on with the unboxing. Are these scissors gonna do it? These are pathetic, aren't they? Ow! Right, we're in. Okay, so I didn't get myself a beauty advent calendar this year. I think I spoke about it in one of my other vlogs. Basically, last year I got the Look Fantastic advent calendar and it was amazing. I loved it, but I didn't really use everything in it. I kind of accumulated all the products that I wasn't going to use. I ended up having a lot of waste. I ended up giving a lot of it away. So it wasn't really value for money. So I thought, you know what, this year, although I really want one, although I really want to open something every single morning, I'm just going to stick to a chocolate advent because it's not worth it. So I didn't get myself a beauty advent. And then I seen this and I was like, you already know I'm about to treat myself. There's a really need for this amount of packaging. I just don't think there is. So this is the Cosmetips times Sarah Ashcroft box. Now, I've never bought anything from Cosmetips before, and the first I ever heard of them was when they did the box with Molly May. They did Cosmetips times Molly May and she came out with a box with loads of products in it for a really discounted price, but that box didn't really speak to me. There was a lot of makeup in there. I don't really wear makeup that often. There was just a lot of things that I was just buying it for the sake of buying it. So I was like, not gonna get it, not gonna jump on the hype, not gonna get it. And then I seen this one advertised. Seen this one advertised last week and everything in this box just spoke to me. I thought this is actually a really good deal because everything in this box is genuinely things that I would buy, want to try, actually own, and I'm about to run out of. So I thought, you know what? This is a bargain. So I jumped on this. Well, in fact, I texted my sister and I was like, have you seen this? And then she was like, get me one. And then I was like, okay, well, if you're getting one, I'm getting one. She was like, well, if you're getting one, I'm getting one. So we both got one. And hers came yesterday and I did have a little sneak peek inside it. Was super excited. Mine obviously just came today. So I thought I would do a little unboxing. Let me... So when we open her up, it comes with this little card inside that tells you all of the products that are inside. And then, isn't she beautiful? Let's see if I can do this without ripping it. Oh, okay. More packaging. And didn't do that one as gracefully. This is what she looks like inside. How unreal is that? Is that where you were before? I don't really know, but it'll do. First of all, it's very aesthetically pleasing, the way that all of the products just like slot nicely together. I wonder if they planned that. But anyways, yeah, when I seen this box, I thought this is all stuff I would genuinely buy, I genuinely have tried and love. I've been wanting to try, so I thought this is like the perfect opportunity to get all of these products for a really discounted price and just stock up, try a few new things out. So I'm just going to run through what is included in the box. Does it tell you how much everything is worth? I'm pretty sure everything is worth about £400. Am I really going to have to do mental maths here because it's not in here? I'm not adding all this up. Hang on. I cannot find it anywhere. Right. So, concluded, everything in the box, if bought full price, is worth £409 and I paid £110 for the box. So that's like a £300 discount. I'd say that was pretty good. I mean, it's not a good discount if you didn't need any of this stuff or you didn't want to try any of this stuff. In that case, you are just spending £110, not saving £300, which I guess if you look at it that way, it's not that good a discount. But if it is stuff you want to try anyways and you were going to go out and buy, then you might as well get everything in the box. So let's run through it all. First thing that is just absolutely staring at me is this Revitalash Cosmetics. I think it's an eyelash conditioning. Yeah, an eyelash conditioner. Now, I've never tried this before, but I've heard of Revitalash. I've heard very, very good things. And this eyelash conditioner is £110. £110 for this eyelash conditioner. So that is the price of the entire box. So if you just bought this, you might as well get everything else for free. So I think that's pretty impressive. I've never tried this. I've heard really good things. I don't really have a problem with like short eyelashes, so I never really bother with like eyelash serums and whatever, but excited to try this out. She raves about it, and in here it says it's an award-winning eyelash serum. 98% reported improved lash appearance, healthier looking lashes and stronger lashes. So stay tuned. If you guys want me to do an update on when I start using this, I'm probably going to start in 10 minutes after I've finish filming this video, but if you do want an update on this, then let me know and I can definitely let you know. I don't know how long it takes to notice results, but I'm guessing it's at least a couple of weeks, so we'll see. Okay, next is this Elemis Rose it's the Elemis Pro Collagen Rose Facial Oil. Now, I absolutely love Elemis products. I think they're like really bougie, they can be a little bit pricey. This face oil is £67. Now, you know me, you know I love skincare, but I ain't spending £67 on a face oil. Nuh-uh, no way, £67. It's not for me, but it was free, because all I paid for, all I paid for was this, so this is all free at this point. So let's see how big a bottle you get. The size of this bottle for £67. I am sorry. I am sorry, Elemis. This is 15 mil. I was expecting the big bottle. This is very small. Surely the 15 mil is not £67. Let me investigate. It is. It's £67 for the 15 mil. I mean, this better turn me into like a Greek goddess or something, because it's small, is all I'm saying. Not that I'm not excited to try it, but this is something that I would never have bought if it wasn't in this box. But I'm excited to try it out. You know me, I love skincare. Always in the market to try some good quality skincare. Let's move on. This I was really, really excited about. This is the Dr. Jart Psychopair Tiger Grass Colour Correcting Treatment. Now, I've seen Sarah Ashcroft actually rave about this. I watched in one of her videos, she used this and it literally transformed her face. It took away like any redness, any like bluish kind of colour. It just completely, it colour corrected. It made her whole face look like it was photoshopped. So I actually really wanted to try this, but never got around to buying it. I don't know, it obviously wasn't that high up on my list, but I did really, really want to try it. I think I forgot about it and then I seen it in this box. So I was like, do you know what, that's actually a really good deal, because this is £37 on its own, which is pricey, but you do get a pretty big jar. Oh, and it comes with a cute little spatch. Yeah, it's a pretty big jar, so I guess that is gonna last a while, but it's really good to use. I'm saying it's really good, I've never tried it, but apparently it's really good to use under makeup, just to kind of completely colour correct and give yourself like a blank canvas. On no makeup days, if you've just got redness, or like me, I've still got some leftover scars down here, so that would be really good to just kind of blur them and get rid of all the redness, even out my complexion. I really don't wear makeup very often at all, so I thought this would be perfect for me to kind of pair with your moisturiser to give you that glow, healthy skin when you're not wearing makeup. So I was really excited to try this, and still am very excited to try this. Next is the Colour Wow Shine Spray. Now, I have quite a few shine sprays and I like quite a few shine sprays, so I wasn't really in the market for a new shine spray, but happy to try it out. I've heard really good things about Colour Wow with like their heat protectants and their colour protectants, and now I have an extra shine spray from them. I really like the Kenra shine spray, I really like the Way shine spray, Tony and Guy do one. Like, I'm not really fussy on my shine sprays, I just use it to finish off my curls. So I'm excited to try this one. I don't think this will ever come in wrong, and I've got back stock of shine sprays now, so I'm happy with this. I forgot to say, this is £26 for, well, at full price, for 160ml. So, I mean, it's not a cheap shine spray, but the Way ones, the Kenra ones, sit around that price point anyway. So that's pretty standard if you want like a more high-end hair product. This is one of the things I was most excited about in this box. And this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Freeze. And then it also comes with the Anastasia Brow Freeze applicator. I use the, is it called Pink Honey? I think it's called Pink Honey, or it might be called Pink Honey Glue, one of the two. I use that to stick up my brows to get that like laminated brow effect, and I absolutely love it. But I am starting to run out of it, and I either really wanted to try this, or I really wanted to try the Refi Beauty Brow Sculpt. And I was going to get the Refi Beauty Brow Sculpt, I was going to pay for that, but then this was included in this box, as I read. I don't need both, let me just try this one out. I've heard that this one is one of the best in the market, so I am really excited to try this one. I love my Pink Honey one, but it was just running low and I was just ready to try something new. So it's a pretty small pot, but I can't imagine that you need very much of it, so I imagine this will last quite a while. And I love that you get the applicator with it. I think that's really cool. Don't really know what this side's for. I guess it's to like scoop it out. Don't really know, but I'm excited to try this the next time I do my makeup. Price point wise, the Brow Freeze is £22, which I think is pretty standard for like a high-end makeup product. But then the applicator is £16. Yeah, £16, which I think is pretty pricey for a spoolie, to be honest, if that's what it is. You can get like 100 of them on Amazon for like £2.99. But anyways, it's £16. The next product we have is the Ulla Henriksen Dark Spot Toner. Now, I've had this before and I really, really liked it, but I did only have the smaller bottle. So this is the 190ml bottle, which retails for £23. And I had the miniature version and I did really like it, but then it just ran out and I never got around to repurchasing it. I had other toners to use, but I think this has probably come at the perfect time because I do have some leftover scarring. So I think this will be really good for that if you suffer with like hyperpigmentation, redness, acne scarring, anything like that. This is a really nice toner, and I think that's an all right price, £23 for this big bottle. I don't know, I think that's an all right price for like a high-end-ish kind of skincare. So I really like Ulla Henriksen. I think it's a really, really nice brand. I like a lot of their products. Now, this next product was the main reason I decided I was like definitely gonna buy the box. When I seen this was in it, I was like, obviously. So this has just run out for me, like literally last week. I have this product, I love this product, and it just ran out. And I did ask my sister to get me one for Christmas. I was like, I can wait, I can hang on until Christmas, it's only like 2 weeks. But then I seen it was in this box, so I quickly messaged her and I was like, don't bother getting me it because it's in the Sarah Ashcroft box. Now, this is the Elemis, what's it called, Pro Collagen Cleansing Balm. And I absolutely love this. I use this all the time to take my makeup off. Pretty much every single time I'm wearing makeup, this is what I'm using. It comes with a little face cloth, which is super cute. And then it is this big tub of makeup remover, basically. It's a cleansing balm. Scoop out a tiny little bit, rub it between your hands, and use it to take off your makeup. I actually used it in my nighttime skincare routine, which I will leave a link to down below if you want to go check it out. But this is 100 grams in this one. So that retails for £44. So that's pretty pricey. So I was really excited when I seen it in this box because that was either money I was going to spend or my sister was going to spend anyways. So I thought, might as well get it in the box because obviously you're getting it at a way discounted price. We're almost at the end. Okay, next is the Philip Kingsley Elasticizer Therapies Deep Conditioning Treatment. I've had this before. I got it in my Look Fantastic Advent last year. Used it up. Absolutely loved it. So I thought, happy to try out another one. This retails for £22.50 and try and get this open. Oh, the box is cute. Oh, and it comes with a little cute shower cap. How cute is that? But it's a decent size for £22, but I mean, I use a lot of hair masks, so that won't last me very long. But I really like it. It's a really nice product. The Philip Kingsley products are really nice. Now, this is the only makeup product in here, and this is the Huda Beauty Tiger Wild Obsessions eyeshadow palette. I have a couple of Huda Beauty palettes and I absolutely love them. One thing I love about them is, obviously the shadows are really nice, but one thing I love about them is how small and travel friendly they are. This is the perfect type of thing to take with you if you're like staying overnight somewhere or you're going on a holiday and you don't want to lug around like that big Morphe palette. This is like a really nice alternative because it always has like one of everything in there. You've always got like a transition colour, you've got a nice sparkle. It's always like a full face in a palette. So let's have a look. Oh, those are the colours, and I think it looks a little bit intimidating on first glance, but when you actually look, like, these mattes will probably blend out really, really nicely. You've got a couple of glitters for the lid, something a little bit darker for the crease. Like, I think that's actually really cute, especially for the festive season with all the glitters. I like this. This retails for £27 for this little palette, so a very good deal, I say. Two products left. Next is a face mask, a sheet mask, and I absolutely love sheet masks, but I am quite fussy about which sheet masks I use. I really like the Pixi ones, I really like the Garnier ones. There's another brand that I really like and I cannot remember the name of, but I am quite particular. Some of them I put on and they irritate my skin and I just have to take them straight off. It's by the brand Soulista? Soul Sister? I don't really know how to pronounce that, but it's the Super Hydration Instant Facial Sheet Mask. And yeah, I've never tried it. I love a sheet mask. Hopefully I like this one. Obviously you do only get one, so I don't think you're gonna notice like loads of results, but you'll be able to know whether you liked it or not. And it looks really nice, and this retails for $7.99, so that's quite an expensive sheet mask for just one use, but it's $7.99 anyways. Then last but not least is a little silk scrunchie, and this is by the brand Slip. You know me, I love a silk scrunchie. They're so much better for your hair. They don't damage your hair. They just feel comfier. They're not like pulling and tugging. I love a silk scrunchie, and I like this one because it's really, really thin. I have a lot of silk scrunchies, but they're like big, thick, chunky ones. So I like this one. This was £6.50. Well, the full price is £6.50. And yeah, it's a cute little pink color. And yeah, I think that's cute. So that is everything that's in my box. I'm very excited by this, as you can tell, because I've probably spoke about it for 100 years. This video is probably 100 years long already. But I was very excited about this when it came in. I couldn't wait to unbox it. Thought I would unbox it with you all. So I hope you enjoy my little unboxing. I'm actually about to go and make some Christmas bags for Christmas Day. I don't know if you can see them. I've got them all lined up there, ready to go. But we're going to make just some little like table favours for everyone. We're having Christmas Day at our house, so we're just going to make some like little party bags, almost like little table favours. Just cute things like little drinks and snacks and like just like a little gesture, you know, not like a present, but just like a little gesture. So I'm going to go make that. I'll try and vlog a little bit if I can, but I'm just feeling very festive this year. I'm excited for Christmas. I hope this Christmas is better than last Christmas, because last Christmas, it was a bit rubbish, wasn't it? So we can only hope. I'm going to go put all my products away and just probably line them all up and look at them for the next 5 to 10 minutes. But yeah, thank you for clicking on this video. Don't know what's to come in the rest of the weekly vlog, half weekly vlog, whatever this turns out to be. But I'll see you all when I next pick up the camera. So excited about my box.
Box. Sarah Ashcroft box.
Okay, I'm back. I've made my Christmas bags. I've got changed. Does anyone else get changed like 9 times a day? I do. But I've decided I'm in my Christmas elf spirit and I'm gonna wrap some presents. I'm gonna start my present wrapping. It's like the 7th of December, the 8th of December. I think that's appropriate. I think it's time to start wrapping the presents, putting them under the tree. I'm excited. So I've got my sellotape. Where's my scissors? My scissors, my paper, and my presents. And I'm gonna start wrapping. I've got like silver, white, and a little bit of blue paper this year. I'm usually a gold gal. I usually go for a gold theme, but the tree is white. So like white and silver. So I didn't want to put gold presents underneath. Is that extra? Some might say yes. So I went for a white and a silver theme. We've got some bows, we've got some ribbon. I'm ready to get festive. I can't show you all of the presents because I definitely do think some of the people that the presents are for will be watching this video, but I'll try my best to show you some things, maybe, what I wrap. I don't really know. That's my sister. 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 There for my sister. She's got a lot of presents. There for my sister. Right. I'ma get to wrapping. I'm just gonna show up and I'm just gonna start wrapping because I haven't really got enough space here. Right. done. That was super tiring, but I'm glad I got not much of my wrapping done at all, to be honest. I did like one person. I was like, right, I'm going to get this out of the way. Did like one full person. I'm going to go put this under the tree and then I'm going to wind down and get ready for bed. So I'll speak to you all the next time I pick up the vlog. Bye. It's me again. I know I literally just put down the vlog and I keep picking it back up, but I was going to take my makeup off and I thought I would try out something and do it with you all. Also, apologies for the lighting in this bathroom. I know it's really dark, but the whole bathroom is really black, so it's really hard to get good lighting in here at night. Hopefully you can see, okay, what is going on. But I was just about to take the little bit of makeup that I have on off. I don't have much on. I literally have a little bit of tinted moisturiser and a little bit of blush and a tiny little bit of mascara. So not much at all. But I did just go and pick up like my go-to makeup removing products. And then I remembered I had these. So I got these quite recently because I go through a lot of cotton pads. Like I use micellar water every day. I use like eye makeup remover. So I do go through a lot of cotton pads, which I know isn't good. I know isn't good for the environment. So I did get these to try these out. So these are like similar to the Face Halo, which I know is like the signature brand for these. But this is by Magnetone London, the Wipe Out Swipes it's called. And you get two in here. So you get a pink one and a grey one, and they're really, really soft. They feel really soft and fluffy, and it says they remove makeup with just water. So the instructions say how to remove makeup with just water, warm water only, no chemicals or cleansers needed, reusable up to 1,000 times, put in the washing machine, perfect for travel. When you're ready to wipe away your makeup, wet your swipe with warm water, use a circular motion to gently wipe away your makeup. So I'm going to try it out. Does it work? It says it just needs warm water. Now, I'm not convinced a cloth and warm water can take all my makeup off. I mean, it might take it off, but is it going to, like, take it off? So, let's see. Run my warm water. Okay, so I've soaked it with the water. That did circular motions, didn't it? I mean, it's definitely bringing my makeup off, but is it like bringing it off is the question. It is working. Let's wet it again and do the other side. Let's do the other side. Okay. It definitely is bringing it off. The issue that I have is this is very small, so I literally had tinted moisturiser on, that was it, a little bit of blush, and this is like getting full pretty quick. So if I had a full face on, I don't know how this would do. But I mean, it definitely is bringing it off. I'm in shock, this is working. Okay, I'm actually a bit shook. This is like really worked. You can see how dirty it is, which is a bit gross, sorry, but that clearly means it's took my makeup off and it's done actually a really good job. I would definitely still go in with another cleanse. I would not just leave my face like this. I would at least go in with either a balm cleanser or just like a regular facial cleanser, definitely. I wouldn't just leave it as it is. However, I'm actually really, really, really impressed with this. I do think if you had a full face of makeup on, you would need to use both, which is a bit annoying because if you do wear makeup every day, if these are in the wash, you're not going to be able to use them. But I guess it's little and often, isn't it? If you are using cotton pads every single day, you could switch to these once or twice a week. While they're not in the wash, you could use them. Or eventually you might build up a bit of a collection to the point where you've got some more rather than just two. And you could use them every single day. So I'm really, really impressed with this. I don't know if they can replace cotton pads to do like toner and things, because it does say don't use any cleanser or chemicals. So I don't think you could put like a toner on this and use it. I think it would just absorb the product, but for taking your makeup off, I'm really impressed with that. So again, they are the Magnetone London Wipe Out Swipes. So I'm gonna go in with my second cleanse. I'm just gonna use my La Roche-Posay cleanser and then get ready for bed. So this time I'm definitely ending the vlog tonight, and I'll see you all when I next pick it up. Thank you.
says, I can only but apologise for the chaotic end to this vlog. I don't really know what happened. I kind of forgot I was vlogging, didn't really get much footage, and it's the end of the weekly vlog now. I think the last time I spoke to you all was a couple of evenings ago. I was doing some present wrapping and things, and then I did go out last night and I fully intended to vlog. I was just having a good time. I forgot. I did film a get ready with me before I went out, so that will be going up soon. And then I was gonna save that as like a separate video and continue and vlog like the night out and everything. I went out for my like Christmas party with my friends. We went for some food. There was like 10 of us who went to a restaurant, and then we went on like a bit of a night out afterwards. But I got like 2 clips, so you will have seen those, and I know that they made no sense because there was no introduction to what was going on, where I went or what happened, so that's why I came on to explain. But yeah, sorry that I didn't get much more footage of that. It was a really good night, and you can probably tell by the little croak in my voice, maybe a little bit too much of a good night. And we have a little injury. I've sprained my ankle again, so I currently have like a little bandage on it. I basically went over on my ankle probably about 5 years ago now. I like twisted over on it, and it's just never been right since. It's just really, really weak. So anytime if I wear heels or if I like step on it a little bit funny or in the gym or anything, it can just ball over really, really easily. So that happened last night when I was walking, and woke up this morning, it's really swollen, it's really sore. So I've got a little bandage on it, a little bit of an injury, but I'll be okay. It's happened before, I'll be okay. So yeah, just apologies again for the little bit of the chaotic ending to the vlog. It wasn't really a weekly vlog, it was like half a week vlog, but I am going to go ahead and end it here because my intention was to vlog last night and I failed, I'm afraid. So thank you so much for watching if you've made it all the way till the end. While you're here, I would really, really appreciate it if you would subscribe to my channel and give this video a like if you enjoyed the vlog nevertheless, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye.